Guys, it's Latrice. Don't worry, we're not here for my hair today. I'm actually going to be doing my little sister's hair, and I'm going to be doing a twist out on her hair. So hopefully it comes out. Hold on. And this is her long, healthy hair. As you can see, she is a slave to the heat. Yes, all of that is her hair, completely, all hers. And her hair actually is natural. It's always been natural. She's never ever had a perm in her hair once, thanks to me. So what I'm gonna be doing is I'll be washing it and putting in a twist out in her hair. And her hair gets really, really big and poofy when it washes. And it also has a lot of shrinkage, so I'm gonna be trying to use some techniques to make sure that the length gets extended, because as you can see, she has really good length on her hair. So as I go along, I'll be making sure I update the video with her twist out. So I'm gonna go wash her hair. My sister's hair, I'm gonna be using the SIM Coconut Co-Wash. And along with that, I'm actually gonna be using a second conditioner. This is something that I'm just now starting to use. I used it on my hair recently, and I'm gonna be using it on hers because it's supposed to help with extra hydration and just retaining the moisture. And as you can see, it has some really good essential vitamins in it. So I'm gonna be using that. And as I go along for the twists and the curls, I'm gonna be using the Shea Moisture Curl.
I just got done washing her hair. Clearly you can see the difference. Like I said, her hair gets really, really poofy. It shrinks up a ton. So I'm gonna have to do my best to extend the curls and to make sure that she's able to get her length back. Detangling her hair while you're washing it is more trouble than it's worth, because as you add water, it just tangles right back up. So there's no point in trying to detangle her hair while you're washing it. So what I do is I'm just gonna go ahead and put in whatever leave-in conditioner I'm gonna put in, and I'll detangle it piece by piece. So as I section it, I'll put some product in and then try and finger detangle it. If not, then of course I'll use my little brush. But yeah, so this is her hair once it's washed. So I'm gonna go ahead and start to try and detangle it now.
So what I'm gonna be doing is sectioning off her hair so that I can start the twists. So I'm gonna be doing the back first, and I'm gonna be doing it in flat twists down. And what I like to use is, I always like to add in some extra tea tree oil. I would also usually add in some coconut oil, but I don't have that with me today, so I'm just gonna be using the tea tree. And of course, the curl enhancing smoothie as I go along. And my brush to help with the detangling. So I'm finished twisting her hair. The twist all around. So typically what would happen is let the twist stay in overnight to air dry and then take them out. But what I want to do is I want to speed up the drying process. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to let her sit under the dryer at a low temperature so that it doesn't really frizz, so that we can speed up the drying and I can take out the twists today instead of tomorrow. As you can see, I'm starting to take out her twists. I let it sit under the dryer for a bit. Now what you can do is, if you want it to really curl up, you can leave the twist in a lot longer or overnight. But since we're dealing with a certain time frame, we're taking them out now, and it's giving us a nice big and crinkly. So we finally got all the twists taken out. Look. Oh.